Chef Mark Geyer is half of the award-winning culinary duo Mark and Clark. Mark and his partner, Clark Frazier, got their start in San Francisco, but headed east to Maine to open their first restaurant, Arrows.
As pioneers in the farm-to-table movement, Mark and Clark helped put Maine on the culinary map. They've since opened MC Perkins Cove, also in Maine, and most recently, MC Spiedo in Boston. Mark and Clark were named Best Chefs Northeast by the James Beard Foundation, and we're happy to welcome the M in MC, Chef Mark Geyer, to The Dish. Good
Thank
morning.
Thank you so much. A pleasure to be here.
Great to be here.
Thank
this
you.
Looks
it's wonderful.
Spectacular.
It's a wonderful, the Grand Tortellini Pie, which is sort
wow.
of the star of the show here.
I've been looking forward to it. They showed this pictures of us like yesterday, and I was like, I cannot wait for this.
This is certainly
it's
the first
a real light
of these
lunch,
we've had.
You know?
So what are the layers in the tortellini?
Well, there's a couple of different meat sauces, you know, pork and veal. There's carrots. We actually cheated a little bit, you know, they weren't using tomatoes then, but we did use just a little bit of tomato paste in this dish because we've worked with all these recipes. We read these old books, and
let's
it was
not
really
talk, let's just
fascinating.
Eat. This is so good.
Oh. Well, you said back then, this whole entire meal is based on the Italian Renaissance.
It really is, and it was interesting reading about you know, the different, the first celebrity chefs, Martino de Como, and you know, he was probably the first celebrity chef, and he was the first person to actually put recipes in writing and
really?
Actually, you know, wrote a cookbook in, you know, in the 15th century. So it's fascinating that this all happened, as, you know, so long ago. And we still have records of this, like Leonardo's salad, which is, it's one of my favorite salads. I eat it in the restaurant every time I'm there. And it's fennel and lemon juice and this great vinaigrette with mint and thyme and herbs that I would normally wouldn't use together. But they just work together so well.
All right, and what are we drinking, Mark?
We are drinking a supposed 14th century Manhattan, and it is cocktail time for you, right?
Yes.
They were making Salud. Manhattans in 14th century?
Well, we are now, but we're using some of the older ingredients. There's very interesting bitters in here, cherries, made with cherries, and then a amaretto-type liqueur, and then bourbon, and of course, sweet vermouth. But the sweet vermouth has a very different taste. It's something you could actually drink almost like Campari by itself.
It's really smooth.
Very smooth.
How does a guy who started off studying pre-med, pre-pharmacy, take such a different route?
Losing your mind, probably. I don't know. It was, you know, I enjoyed school. I wasn't the best student, but I was fascinated by pharmacy, and then I wanted to be a doctor, and I was doing my understudy. But I was also working in restaurants at the time, and I thought, well, this is a lot more interesting. Mm-hmm. This is a lot more fun. I think I'd have a lot, you know, much more fun doing this. So I wasn't the best student, and I thought, you know what, maybe I'll see if I'm better at cooking. Mm-hmm. And apparently, I guess I did that right.
Well, you've been cooking actually since, I mean, you were inspired very early on by food.
Very early on. I started cooking probably when I was 8 or 10 years old. I mean,
wow.
I know chefs always say that, but I was, you know, from a big family, 7 kids, and so my mother loved having a little bit of a break. So I cooked with my mother, and when I was 10 years old, I was fascinated by this recipe for this Easter bread. And you baked it in coffee cans, so I had to keep, you know, back then coffee came in a can, and we had to keep saving the can so I could bake this Easter bread, and it was fascinating. It was really a lot of fun.
You know, we meet so many chefs here that really are strong believers in farm to table. Mm-hmm. But when I look back at the timeline, I mean, 20 years ago, people really weren't into farm to table.
It was a long time ago. And, you know, we really started that out of necessity because when Clark and I moved to Maine in 1988, it was a different world then. And, mm-hmm. and you know, you couldn't buy everything, you know, right around the corner. Coming from California, we were used to really no seasons. You know, you could get whatever, whenever. So the whole farm to table, for us at least, was sort of born out of necessity.
Right.
Because we couldn't get the ingredients we wanted, we couldn't get the quality we wanted, and we wanted to really grow things that were, you know, of the moment.
You were born in Dayton, right? But you ended up, before you were in Maine, you were in San Francisco, which is where you met Clark.
Exactly.
When you were working in a restaurant there. What inspired you out in San Francisco?
We worked for Jeremiah Tower at Stars in San Francisco, and he was kind of the father of California cuisine and I think somewhat of New American cuisine. So we were inspired by the freshness of the food, the, you know, light, clean, and it was very seasonal and you know, simple sauces. And so that kind of got us interested in, you know, gardening and farming, and you know, there was the whole, you know, Alice Waters and Chez Panisse and that whole movement. And I think we were inspired by that, but trying to interpret that in Maine was a whole different kettle of fish, so to speak.
I want to hand this dish to you and get your signature
on it. Love to.
And while you're signing, we want to ask you if you could have this meal with any person, past or present, excluding Clark, who would that person be?
Boy, that's a tough question. You really got to narrow that down. But you know what? I think I'd like to have this dinner with my mother. I really would. I think she would absolutely love it.
Absolutely delicious meal, Chef Mark.
It's fabulous.
Thank you so much. And for more on Mark Geyer and the dish, head to our website at CBS This Morning.